Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace, blessings and mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon all of you. Respected teachers and my dear brothers and sisters, a very good morning to all of you. I am Afnan Fazli with the seminar topic, Earth Lineage Circuit Breakup. Now before I go to the nitty-gritties of my topic, let me show you the overview of the subtopics which I would like to cover. First of all, I will explain what ELCB actually is, then followed by why there is need of installing ELCB in our homes, then design of ELCB, operation, types of ELCBs, function of test button in ELCB, nuisance stripping, and at last, difference between ELCB and LCB. Now, as we all know, power system protection is the most important requirement for industrial or domestic purposes. For this reason, ELCBs can be used to protect the appliances from the damages caused due to the earth leakage. So we can define ELCB as an electrical wiring device that disconnects the power supply whenever it detects any imbalance of currents between the phase conductor and the line conductor. Such an imbalance can be caused due to the leakage current flowing through the body of a person who is grounded or accidentally touching the energized part of a circuit. A lethal shock can result from these conditions, which is why ELCBs are used, as they can detect even the smallest of the currents flowing through the body of a person to the earth. One more thing about ELCB is that they can operate within 25 to 40 milliseconds before electric shock can drive the heart into ventricular fibrillation, that is the most common cause of death due to electric shock. Now, ELCBs are mostly used in TT earthing systems. In TT earthing systems, what happens is the protective connection of the consumer is provided by the local connection to the earth, independent of any earth connection at the transformer. The biggest advantage of using TT earthing systems is that it is free from high and low level noises that usually come through the neutral of various electrical equipments connected to the system. Now, the next topic that I would like to discuss is why there is need of installing ELCB in our homes. There are many such installations which usually have high earth impedance. These installations are dangerous and a safety risk if a live earth fault current flows through them. Now, coming to the practical part, if a person touches a faulty electrical equipment, typically a metal part which is connected to the earth, and an electric current will flow through that person to the earth. Now, this electric current is too small to trip a fuse or an LCB. That is why ELCBs are used, as they can detect even the smallest of the currents flowing through the earth. Now comes the design part of ELCB. This arrangement consists of the two mechanical switches, surge coil, current transformer, test button and the test resistor. The surge coil is connected to the trip coil so as to detect the residual current. The function of the two mechanical switches is to trigger and to switch off the power supply in case of any earth leakage. Also, the test button and the test resistor is used in order to check whether ELCB is operational or not. This I will discuss later on in detail. Now, as you can see, the line wire, the neutral wire and the surge coil, they all are bound on a common transformer core. Also, it can be seen that the line wire, the neutral wire are wound in such a way so as to produce an opposite magnetic flux. Now, if the same current passes through both the wires, therefore, their magnetic flux will cancel out under healthy conditions. Now, coming to the next topic, that is working of ELCB. Under normal conditions, what happens is, when there is no earth fault, or we can say when there is no leakage current flowing to the earth, the current through the phase wire will pass through the load and the same amount of current will return back to the neutral. In this case, suppose if 5 amperes of current flow from phase to the load, then the same 5 amperes will return back to the neutral. As net current is zero, therefore the magnetic flux produced by both phase and the neutral wires will cancel out under healthy conditions. In this case, the ELCB will not trip the circuit. Now, what happens under fault conditions is, when there is an earth fault, suppose a current of 3 amperes flow to the earth. As a result, the current through the neutral coil will not be the same as that of the phase coil. As a result, the magnetic flux produced in the transformer core will not be balanced anymore. There will be some net magnetic flux, called as residual flux. This residual flux, what it does is, it produces EMF in the surge coil, which in turn induces current in the tripping coil so as to disconnect the power supply. This is how ELCB works under fault conditions. Now comes the types of ELCBs.
We usually have two types of ELCBs.
One is voltage ELCB and another is current ELCB.
Now what happens in voltage ELCB?
As you can see from the circuit diagram of voltage ELCB, it consists of a relay loop such that its one terminal is connected to the metal body of an equipment to be protected against the earth leakage, and another terminal is connected to the earth. Now if any installation failure occurs or the live wire touches the metal body of an equipment, potential difference gets produced in the coil connecting the metal body and the relay. This potential difference will cause a current to flow to the relay coil. Now if voltage crosses the predetermined level, say 50 volts, the current in the relay becomes sufficient enough to activate the circuit breaker so as to disconnect the power supply. This is how voltage ELCB works. Now what happens in current ELCB? Current ELCBs are also called as residual circuit current breakers, RCCBs. It consists of a two-winding current transformer having two primary windings in the form of phase and neutral and one secondary winding in the form of relay coil. Now under normal conditions, what happens is the current through the relay coil is zero. Now under fault conditions, small amount of current will flow to the earth. As a result, the current between the phase and the neutral will not be balanced anymore. This induces the current in the relay coil, which will sense the leakage and hence accordingly will send the signal to the circuit breaker so as to disconnect the power supply. This is how current ELCB works in order to protect the appliances from the earth leakage. Now the next topic is the function of test button in ELCB. If you get to see an ELCB, you will find a button with alphabet T written over it. This symbol T represents the test button. Now ELCBs are provided with the test button so as to test its reliability. What I mean by reliability here is that whether ELCB will trip the circuit every time we press this test button. Now coming to the circuitry behind this test button, as you can see, the test button and the high level resistor are connected across the line wire. Now what happens in this circuit is, when we press this test button, current starts to flow in the circuit depending upon the resistance. Now this current flows through the line wire, but it doesn't return back to the neutral. As a result, there will be unbalance of currents between the line and the neutral, and therefore ELCB trips, thereby indicating the proper functioning of ELCB. Now the next thing that I would like to discuss is the nuisance tripping in ELCB. As can be seen from the topic itself, ELCB has the tendency to disconnect the power supply every time it detects any imbalance. Such nuisance tripping can be caused due to the faulty electrical wiring or lightning strikes, or it can also happen due to the burden currents. By the way, burden currents are those currents that are generated in the old electrical equipments having low insulation resistance. Now, nuisance tripping has got its own advantages as well as disadvantages. From advantage point of view, ELCB will trip the circuit every time it detects any imbalance of currents between the line conductor and the neutral conductor. This is done for the safety purposes. From disadvantage point of view, it can become nuisance as one has to tip the ELCB over and over again. Now coming to the last topic that I would like to discuss is the difference between ELCB and MCB. As we all know, MCB stands for miniature circuit breaker. It's an updated version of fuse. What MCB does is, it will disconnect the power supply only if it senses supply current is greater than the rated current of MCB. Now usually MCBs come with the rating of 10 amperes, 16 amperes or 32 amperes. What it means is, if the current is within the specified limits of 10, 16 or 32 amperes, MCB will not trip the circuit, which is way past the lethal level for humans to get shocked. That is why RCBs come into picture. They are designed in such a way that so as to protect the humans from electric shocks. They monitor the amount of current flowing through the live wire and returning back through the neutral. So in a nutshell, we can say that MCBs are used to save wiring, whereas ELCBs are used to save human lives. Thank you.